Hey everyone, it's Kelly and welcome back to another episode of Dying the Dead. In this video, I'm going to be staining the bones of my bird. I'm going to be using a chemical called alizarin red, and this is going to stain the bones of my specimen a nice pretty pinkish reddish color. I'm going to be using a mixture of potassium hydroxide flakes, distilled water, and my alizarin red powder. Once I prepare my solution, I'm going to be transferring my bird into it and leaving it there for about 24 hours or less because you want to look for a really nice pinkish red color. Leaving your specimen in the alizarin red for too long can stain it a really deep dark purple. So here are some of the things that you're going to be needing. My specimen, the bird which has been sitting in the trypsin digestion solution, two jars or containers, one to prepare the potassium hydroxide solution in and the other to prepare the bone stain in. Your scale, weighing papers or weighing boats, your tweezers, a plastic knife or a stir stick, nitrile lab gloves, your lab goggles, your 100 milliliter graduated cylinder, distilled water, your potassium hydroxide flakes, and last but not least, your alizarin red powder. To start us off, I'm going to be preparing a 0.5 molar potassium hydroxide solution. To make a 0.5 molar potassium hydroxide solution, we first need to know the molar mass of potassium hydroxide, or KOH. Potassium hydroxide consists of three elements: potassium, oxygen, and hydrogen, and each of those elements has its own individual atomic mass. Potassium being 39 grams per mole, oxygen being 16 grams per mole, and hydrogen being 1 gram per mole. To find the molar mass, we just add all three of those values together and we get about 56 grams per mole. Since we are preparing a 0.5 molar solution, we are going to be multiplying the molar mass of potassium hydroxide by 0.5 molar, which is going to give us 28 grams of potassium hydroxide flakes per liter. I'm only going to be preparing about 250 milliliters of a 0.5 molar potassium hydroxide solution. So if 28 grams of potassium hydroxide flakes go into 1 liter, 14 grams are gonna go into 500 milliliters, and 7 grams are gonna go into 250 milliliters. What I'm gonna be doing is first preparing my 0.5 molar potassium hydroxide solution, and then from that, I'm going to prepare my alizarin red or my bone stain solution. And in order to do that, I'm going to measure out about 100 milliliters of my 0.5 molar potassium hydroxide solution, and then weigh out about 10 milligrams or 0.01 grams of my alizarin red powder. When I add those together, I'm just gonna mix them really well and then place my specimen inside. All right, so let's get started. Solution sit for about 5 minutes, it turned clear.
Thank you.
solution and it's turned purple as you can see. So now I'm going to be transferring my specimen, the bird, from the trypsin digestion solution into the alizarin red bone stain.
The next day.
Alright, so we're back and my bird has been soaking in the alizarin red solution for about 24 hours now. We're just going to take a look at what it looks like now. Alright, so here is my specimen. I first want to just start off by saying that I personally feel that the bird is slightly overstained from the alcyon blue cartilage stain. You can tell by the residual blue on the tissues, on the legs, on the wings, and kind of like a lot on the front chest plate. It's quite potent, it's there. I should have probably just left it in there for about 24 or less hours. But we'll have to see how well it clears when we get to the next step. Looking underneath the ribs, I think that looks super cool. You can see where the bone stain is, you can see where the cartilage stain is. You can see where the bones transition into the cartilage on inside the chest cavity. On one side of the chest, you can see where the ribs are missing towards the back of the spine, and that's presumably from whatever attacked it before it got into my hands. Spreading out the wings, you can see where the bone stain is through some of the tissues because those did become really transparent. It looks all like a little dinosaur. Turning the bird over, you can see where the spine is, which looks really cool. You can see the back of the hip bones, which also looks super neat as well. The tissues on the legs and stuff do slightly look transparent, but I feel that they could have been more transparent had they been in trypsin just a little bit longer. The feet, however, one of them looks a little wonky. It's kind of all bleh. And the other one is, you know, curled really nicely. I don't know what happened there. I tried to fix it when it went into trypsin, but it didn't work out. So in conclusion, I feel that my bird has come out pretty well so far. I'm excited to move on to the next clearing and bleaching step. However, the bones are quite a dark purple. I'm gonna say that they're a little bit overstained. I was looking for more of a reddish pink color, but that's okay. We'll really see what the bones actually look like and what the color truly is for these bones once we start clearing and bleaching them. I think that if I ever get a hold of another bird, I won't stay in the cartilage stain or the alcyon blue stain for as long, about 2 days. I'll stay in there probably about one or less. Alright, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any questions or anything like that, please leave it down below in the comments. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe to my channel for more videos, and if you like what you're seeing, also don't forget to read the description down below and check all of the links and things down there. There might be some cool stuff and things I didn't really get to talk about in today's video. And I hope you guys join me next time for the next video, which will be the clearing and bleaching of my specimen. Alright, see you guys next time. Bye!